2 days, and you're already crawling on a lap of a little schoolboy here, huh?
Oh, yeah? Well, where did you sneak off to yesterday,
Excuse me?
What's the name of that motel, Jake? Yeah, that's right. He followed you on your little friggin' rendezvous.
Why you got him following me?
Yeah, I'm beginning to wonder that myself.
Because he is a private detective, and I hired him.
You hired a private detective?
Yes, I did.
That's great. That's
Hello?
Really, really good.
What is this?
I got it.
Yep. Looks like it.
Why'd you hire a private detective there, Stacy, huh?
Because I knew I should never have trusted you.
Are you kidding me? I should never have trusted you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I tell you what. Good luck here with your loser prom date, all right? Because the honeymoon is over. It's done.
What'd you call me?
What are you doing sleeping with my wife, huh?
Oh, anyway. Okay, take it easy there.
Johnny?
Hey, what are you doing sleeping with my wife?
Just take it easy.
Johnny, you just tell me the truth. Were you or were you not with another woman yesterday?
I was.
It's not what you think, Stacy.
Oh!
Oh. Hey, you.
Somebody tell me what the hell is going on here?
Trust me, you don't want to know.
Stacy, just calm down.
Stay away from me.
I brought you a coffee.
Thanks.
I'm keeping the muffin.
Now, that was as good as a concert.
And you stay focused! You, too, will experience the rush! I'm grinding your opponent into the ground!
Somebody needs a hug.
Thank you for volunteering, Landers! First day of practice, I love to give a freshman the chance to wrestle one of my varsity guys. Start the season off with a bang! Bang! Budnick!
Yes, coach?
You and Maggot Landers are gonna go 2 rounds tomorrow.
Sir.
Make that 3 rounds. Any more butts, Landers?
No, sir.
Is it over?
Over? You never felt more alive, have you, Landers?
Well, actually.
Round 3. In 5 minutes.
Hey, I'll have a cheese dog with onions and mustard. Hello? Cheese dog with onions and mustard?
I hear you. I just not hear you.
What?
You in pickup on the line. Order line over there.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Hello, good day. How's the family? What do you want?
I already told you.
You weren't in right line, I no listen. Alexi no like your attitude, but I feel good today, so I give you one more last chance.
Okay, I'll get a cheese dog with onions and mustard.
Order by number only.
Get it. Come on, buddy. Stop making trouble.
Hey, look, it's not me. It's this hot dog guy who's slowing things down.
Excuse me. I show you how I speed things up. Next!
Okay, I'll have a number 6.
You got potatoes in your ears. I say next. You not next. You don't exist no more.
What, just because I don't order by your stupid numbers?
Stupid numbers? Tell you what. Come back tomorrow. I won't serve you then either. Next!
Your smile lights up a room and scoops fish out of the sea. Oh my, I might have a problem.
My king, sorry to barge into your love nest, but did you know that a poetry slam is happening on the island as we speak?
Well, what if we stop speaking?
Your Majesty, King Cowan criminals have gathered illegally in the jungle to recite poetry. Their leader is, wait for it, your brother!
What? Is she
with him?
You betcha. Shut down! Call the guards and arrest the poets.
Sure thing. Guards, release the attack dogs! It's feeding time!
I don't want anybody to get hurt. I don't want them to get the wrong impression of me.
That ship has sailed. You're dating a pelican.
Hey, that's my butt. What is he doing here?
What did Mr. Hall want?
He called to say that... No, let me tell him.
Stop
Stop copying me. You're copying me. No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Both of you, stop. You, Original Stan. What do you say?
I don't think you should call him Original Stan. I'm 24 hours older. That would make me Original Stan. You should call him Stan the Second. Or better yet, Bob.
No, you know what? He's Stan. You're both Stan. What?
Bob? He said that a major electromagnetic disturbance has been detected and that we need to go investigate.
Let's go.
Shotgun!
What do you think you're doing?
I thought maybe...
You were just trespassing in Maddie Clark's cornfield, interfering with a state-run investigation.
Sir, I had a hunch.
Uh-huh.
So I thought, well...
Oh, really? Actually, Deputy, you didn't think. Because if you had thought, you would have left this investigation up to those who are capable of investigating it. I mean, look at you crawling around on the ground, dressed up like a corn stalk. I mean, please. What are you thinking?
I was thinking I had better blend into the cornfield so that I wouldn't be seen, like if I had been wearing a very bright white shirt like yours, sir.